Okay.
You're not supposed to have started.
It's okay. I haven't started. As soon
But
as I
the
press.
red light is on. I don't believe you.
Play a guitar on this, but it won't matter for the tape, I don't think.
No.
I don't think so.
Right.
Hi, Steve.
Are we looking for something? Or...
Yes.
Oh, right. I follow that. Now, the only reason I'm concerned is that if you're going to get up again, we need to just take that off, basically. But it don't take a minute. But... Right. Okay. All right.
Don't want that going off like it did yesterday. My phone.
Oh my God.
Right in the middle of recording.
You never did that, did you?
Yeah.
Fenella, can you just say something? I want to just hear what I'm getting it on this microphone.
The south of France.
That's beautiful, yeah.
Oh, I thought it was off the cuff then.
No, no, darling.
It's not getting in the way, is
no,
it?
No, that's fine. That's fine, actually. Yes, it is. It's fine.
You mean shows and so forth?
Nothing is not to get it, so as to cover your face microphones when you're filming.
Yes, that's right. You know. He's talking about that microphone that he's putting there, so
yeah.
It doesn't cover
the face.
Oh,
this is dead, is it?
Yeah. No, that's for in that, you know, for actually...
Sure.
Yeah.
But this is... I mean, what you mean, will they clash with each other?
No, will that microphone hide your face on camera?
Oh,
yes.
Oh.
We don't want to hide your face.
No.
I do.
Oh.
I want to hide my face.
Oh, oh darling.
He was being very rude. He's got a very nice face, hasn't he?
Lovely. He's a beauty. A natural beauty.
I don't know, I think they'll roll tape and we'll just go through the motions of it. Haunt you forever.
Yeah. Yeah, become my signature.
Could do with maybe having a playback of it or something in the control room.
Yes.
I don't know, I think Tim's...
Some water and things like that.
Some water,
some
mine.
Natural things.
Oh dear.
There was
That's
a bottle
a
of water on here last night. It's gone. Various mugs.
Yeah, this is all the stuff from last time. I can't believe it was all down there on the floor.
Isn't that
extraordinary? Hiding away, ready to be pulled out for another session.
I know, it's incredible. It's incredible.
Shall I pop some in for you?
Oh, yes, thank
yes.
you.
Yes, there we are.
That one was the hardest that I thought. To work out was the Marlene Dietrich one. To work out, that was really quite complicated to work out.
Yes, it was.
That. You wouldn't have thought so on listening to it.
No, I know.
But to work out the actual chords was like...
I know, it was hell.
I had to do it at home. I had to do it at home and keep replaying, you know, like me listening.
Yes.
Keep replaying it.
That's right.
To actually suss out what the actual cards were. You know.
I saw her do it in the film. She really? Showed it a few months ago on Channel 4. Oh, it's a boring film.
The song makes up for it, though, probably.
Yeah, it's a good song. Mm-hmm. And one or two other songs. Mm-hmm. But, yawn. It really was incredible. But she sang it differently.
In the movie?
Yeah.
Than the recorded separate to the movie, is it?
Yeah. I think she's did it more correct.
Do you want to play back this Angels, or should we just do it again to do me playing piano or some keyboards or something?
When we did it the other day, did you play it on?
Yeah, on here.
Yeah.
Not the best guitar.
I don't know whether I'm ready. I feel so embarrassed. I can't begin to tell you because I'm not ready to work.
Right.
No.
Because we've all been sitting upstairs. Yeah. It's not.
To say if we have a rehearsal.
Well, actually, that kind of was what happened just when I was playing guitar. It was like a rehearsal, really. So maybe just do it.
It was like taking notes, really.
Because just where you stopped and I gave you a little leading note or something, and you took it from there.
And through it all, he offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong. And down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me when I come to call. He won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead.
It's quite a nice version, that, actually. Just a voice from piano. It's a bit like the Kylie Minogue did one with the I Should Be So Lucky. And she does it like a poem, and it actually works.
Oh, yeah.
Because the music, people don't realise, the music behind that's really quite clever. The chord sequence is too I Should Be So Lucky. People throw away pop. But you play it on a guitar, play it on a piano, and it's beautiful. And she did it. She did that piece with like an orchestra just as a poem on stage, and it works really well. I could imagine the same kind of thing happening. You know, working with this song, to be honest with you.
Oh, yes, you could do that. Yeah. Yes.
Because it's kind of like...
cold, couldn't you?
Yeah, it's kind of like the way we just done it then. It reminded me very much of that kind of performance.
Does an angel, I sit and wait. Does an angel contemplate my fate? And do they know the places where we go when we're grey and old? Because I have been told that salvation lets their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts humming through my head, and I feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead. Some of that was okay.
It was, yeah, kind of like
some
that.
Some of it wasn't.
Yeah.
Well, Peter Sellers had a big hit with It's a Hard Day's Night, didn't he, really?
What?
Peter Sellers' big hit with A Hard Day's Night.
Yes, but that was meant to be a joke.
It was a joke, yes, I know it was meant to be a joke.
Thank you.
Because the chords on this are so kind of straight, you can almost do, not exactly, but like a Gregorian kind of very, very sort of a medieval chord thing. So it simplifies the music even more against, which is what I kind of quite like about it. So instead of being very fiddly, it can just, you can have little chords.
Let's try that. And down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that life won't break me. When I come to call, he won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead. Yeah, the words aren't quite good enough to speak.
Not quite, but it does work on that level. To a degree, it works on that level.
You could do bits spoken.
Yeah, and maybe the chorus and through it all, maybe just go into the maybe music up a little bit. Yeah, half and half would probably work.
Yes, I think that would work, actually.
Yeah, it would, yeah. Because the other way, it was completely spoken. It does go into that, isn't it a joke? Yeah, and you've got to be very careful on that level, haven't you? Is it art or is it not? You know?
It's nice to have a try.
Yeah, it does work.
A lark. An experiment.
Yeah.
Experimental theatre. Experimental opera. Well, yes. It when it gets to phrases like I'm loving angels instead, spoken, it sounds ridiculous.
Yeah, I think that bit does need to be a song.
Yeah, it's amazing. Things that can be sung. How about doing Blue Monday? Let me just speak it.
Okay.
Yeah. And if you want to sort of do something underneath.
All right then, a bit of experimental theatre there for now. Yeah. I can't do the beat thing, but
what is it? 1, 2, 3.
How does it? I don't know what the key is.
How down, da, da, da. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. How does it feel? How does it feel to treat me like you do when you've laid your hands upon me and told me who you are? I thought I was mistaken. I thought I heard your words. Tell me, how do I feel? Tell me now, how do I feel? Those who came before me lived through their vocations. From the past until completion, they will turn away no more. And I still find it so hard to say what I need to say, but I'm quite sure that you'll tell me just how I should feel today.
Do you find a difference in directors between when you first started and now? Has there been a change?
Well, I don't know. I know there has been a change, but when I started, I didn't kind of notice the directors so much because I started working backstage in a little theatre club, and you know, I wasn't aware whether the director was good or not, just simply that he was the director. And then later on I did review, and that's a different kind of directing from a play.
Yes.
And so is film, obviously. And but I know that everything seemingly changed a lot when suddenly a lot of directors seemed to be coming from university, directly from university. Yes. And so that would be that they kind of would lay more interest on the intellectual context of the play than normally had been thought right in the past, and weren't necessarily awfully good at moving actors around, you know.
Right,
sit
so it wasn't
down,
all...
stand up, that looks bad, that looks good, you know. They had to learn on the hoof.
Right.
Which is, you can't learn except by doing it.
No.
And some of those who started that way became the most incredibly marvellous directors. I think Michael Blakemore is a wonderful director.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know that he knows all there is to be known technically, but he also, he's got a wonderful mind.
Mm-hmm.
And wonderful feeling.
Yes.
So, you know, that's pretty rare.
Yes, it's if presumably they can actually get into the way that you need to feel themselves.
Yes.
Mm.
Or convey it.
Yes.
Or feel it in the first place themselves,
yes.
You know.
Mm.
Say, yes, but that this scene isn't really about that. What it's really about is such and such. And you think, yes. Mm. Or I thought that too, but I didn't like to say it. Or whatever, you know. And then that's lovely.
And would you say comedy was different in that in any respect to other plays?
Oh, comedy is infinitely more difficult because, I mean, it either works or it doesn't, and you get the result immediately. I see a ship in the harbour. I can and I shall obey. But if it wasn't for your misfortunes, I'd be a heavenly person today. And I thought I was mistaken, and I thought I heard you speak. Tell me, how do I feel? Tell me now, how should I feel? Now I stand here waiting. Now I stand here waiting. I thought I told you to leave me when I walked down to the beach. Tell me, how does it feel when your heart grows cold? How does it feel when your heart grows cold? Actually, it's rather amazing.
When you're actually saying it in that, it's not even deadpan, it's just very, very sort of pianissimo kind of voice, and it's just low like that. Rather than, because sometimes when you sing against the music, you do tend to give it a little bit more zest, yes, to it. But like that, sort of low spoken, it kind of, that works at that level, actually.
Yeah, it does.
Very much so.
Yeah. It doesn't have too much whinginess about it.
Which is what you wanted to avoid, I think.
Well, you know.
No, it was the other one, wasn't it, that was whingy? What was the one that was whingy?
This one?
Was it? No, it was, if a bloke sings it, it's fine, you said, but if a woman sings it...
Yes,
Was it this one? Yes. But Blue Moon is more of a whiner, isn't it? Whiner rather than a mourner, so whine.
Yes, that's worse. Yeah, that's right. Because it's sort of...
Monotonic, drone, yeah.
It's got moments where... If it wasn't for your misfortunes, I'd be a heavenly person today. What does it mean?
I don't know.
If everything hadn't gone wrong for you, I'd
be
lovely.
Yeah, I'd be fine. Yeah, everything would be fine in my life. It's all your fault, basically,
isn't
it? It's weird,
yeah. Oh. But
and they must admit the ship, there must be something, but the ship in the harbour. I mean, somehow that just comes out of nowhere.
Absolutely.
Ship in the harbour.
I mean, I like the idea of a ship in the harbour. Like that Kurt Vile song. My ship has sails, my ship has sails that would blow away. Da-dee-doo-doo. It's from Lady in the Dark.
Right.
It's what she dreams, and that's why she goes to the psychiatrist.
Right, but that bears relevance
my
to the
ship
movie.
Has sails that are made of silk. My ship has sails. So I like that. I see a ship in the harbour. And there's a bit there's a song that Lottie Lenya does that's about a ship in the harbour.
What is that?
Show me the way to the next whiskey bar. Oh, you know why. Oh, you know why. From Mahogany.
Right.
That's Lottie Lenya.
Right.
Oh, she's lovely. Have you seen that movie? Trutney Opera.
That's Kurt Vile and Bertolt Brecht. Yeah. Bertolt Brecht, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
That one went a little bit.
This is a movie, and
oh, is it right?
So gorgeous. Mm. And it's very black and white. And there she is, Lottie Lenya, really all young and singing very soprano at that point. Oh, it's lovely.
I've seen that.
Well, I'll give you the details. You got her. Now what should we do?
Well, there's the Kylie Minogue la 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 la, isn't there?
There's la 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 la. You have to learn that all over again. It's so complicated.
I know there's more.
But I will just.
For some people it is, because there's more than three notes. You know?
Exactly. Exactly. One minute. Let's have a little look.
I'm trying to stray away from saying anything slanderous on tape. You know, I'm tempted to say something now and again. I think, no, I better not. You know about a certain artist, and you think, no, I'd better not. You know, not slanderous, but something that's like really a little bit bitchy or something. You know, I was going to something then when I heard that, and I thought, no,
be there Steve, forever.
No, Steve, it will be there.
Yeah,
in archived print. Somewhere, yeah. You know, for someone to pull out of the drop of the hat,
yes,
you know.
Gosh, quite. Yeah, it's always got to be nice. You know, I wish I knew what we're supposed to be doing. I really wish I knew, but I don't. I haven't the slightest idea.
I think
just
wants to get some captures, just kind of in rehearsal, or just doing what we're doing, or natural.
But I mean, I don't know.
Vanilla fielding in rehearsal.
Yeah.
But it's neither one thing or the other,
I know,
is it?
I know what you mean. Yeah, because I suppose we take
it's a half
tiny
remembered and
different approach. Slightly different approach.
Did you see that Rolling Stones film where it was all the preparation of a piece of music? It's similar to this, to that.
What, the Rolling Stones?
Yeah.
I've never seen it.
Mm,
oh, yes. That should be worth a look.
Yes.
Well, is that fairly recently?
Oh, no.
It
was when they were at their absolute fruition.
Oh, it was. Yes, it
yeah.
was.
Wasn't that performance, or was
Sympathy
it?
For the Devil, I think it was.
Oh, was it?
That,
right.
That they were doing on...
What was it?
Sympathy for the Devil, I think it was, that they were doing.
Mm. And they were like learning it and trying
yes,
it this way
yes,
and trying
yes,
it that
right.
way.
Yes, that's right, and the camera was all over the place. I mean, I've got Gabriel and there going all over the place, but I thought it would be very disconcerting for you if I darted all over the
well,
place.
Well, I don't know. Well, I mean, there isn't room, is there? It's just sort of slung up to the ceiling.
Yes, that's right, yes.
A crane shot.
That's right, yes. Yes, indeed. Yes, it does.
I wish David would say something, David and Mike. They'd say, well, do such and such.
They would normally be doing that, wouldn't they?
Yes.
So really, we want them to do that, don't we?
Yeah, yes. Yeah, I suppose.
Will you tell them that we want them to do
I
that?
Think
because
maybe,
it's not really a proper rehearsal.
I think Mike's nipped out for a couple of minutes.
For a couple of minutes. But when he comes back...
Yeah.
He's
up there, actually.
I noticed the first thing he did was kind of dart away. But really, I mean, if you want a proper rehearsal for situation, you need all that. Otherwise, Gabriel's going to have just a load of knobs going in there.
Yes.
Yes.
It's funny, you see, when you learn something specially to then record it, when you finally record it, you know, you've done it, and then because you've had to learn it so fast, you've forgotten it.
That's right.
You know,
I'll
goes
go,
out,
I,
so
I,
doing
I,
it
do
now,
battery,
it's
so
sort of neither one thing nor the other.
Yeah. I know, it's up that, because, you know, when people, you set the cameras up and everything, and it's like... I don't know, it's kind of trying to capture a natural situation in a kind of an unnatural way.
Yes.
And it's very difficult to capture that unless...
But
because
it
can't be
you
planned.
Going.
You can't plan that kind of thing, can you?
Well, it's, you could say, try this, try this. But if it's left to us, it's always more difficult, isn't it?
Yeah, because we're just left to our own. We should just carry on and just do whatever, you know, we should just do...
Fenello, in all these sort of these... The films you've done, which were your favourite directors?
Films? Well, the films were all very specific. You know, they carry on and Doctor.
Yes.
And things. But they're not the directors I think about. The directors I think about are ones I've worked with on television or theatre. Jerry Thomas was very good because he knew exactly what he wanted. And he could edit as he went along.
Yes.
But I'm thinking of directors who made you see something that you wouldn't have done otherwise.
Mm.
Or had a lovely idea of how the play should be. Or,
yes.
They're the ones I...
Are they the ones that communicate better with you?
Well, they're the ones I think about. Oh,
yes.
He's a wonderful director.
Yes.
Actually, man I'm working with at the moment in Dublin is a wonderful director. He's a guy called Michael Scott. and you'll never have heard of him because he directs there.
Yes.
But he's a brilliant director.
So what's his style then?
I don't know, he just knows everything and he doesn't sort of lay it on you in a terrible way.
No.
If sometimes he works with people who are really very minuscule in gift, he tells them how to do it. And he doesn't bother about not telling them how to do it. He tells them how to do it and he tells them in a very clear, not brutal way. He says, do it like this, such and such and such. And they know exactly what he means and then they do it as well as they can because their gift is only little. So they can't do it brilliantly, but they do it successfully. And when he's got really very talented people, he can bring wonderful things out of them. It's just miraculous. And he's very funny, and he's very nice, and it's most unusual.
Yeah.
How does it?
If you want, what we can do is I've got the music, I bought the music today of that. We could put that down and you could do one to that maybe as well.
Let's do that.
Would be a good idea, I think. We to take 5 minutes while we do that as well, which would be good for yourself.
Do it for our own pleasure.
If I could read a book, is that what that song's called?
It's called Blue Monday.
No, that one I was trying to... If I could read a novel... Da, 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 you come da, on the screen.
Da, 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 da,
you were singing it.
Da, 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 da. I don't know what to
if
do.
I'm sure the song's called If I Could Read a Book. It's really going to bug me that. You did sing it the other day. And I said, I adore. Yeah, I said, I adore. That's one of my favourite songs. And I started singing it and you was going, yes, it's really, really good. And you gave the title, but I'm sure that if I could read a book, or if I could something, if I could, I think that's the title of it.
If they asked me, I would write a book.
Is that a song?
Yes, about the way you stand and listen and look. It's from Paul Jerry.
I tell you, I've heard a lot of people murder recently, some Cole Porter stuff. I'm one of there's a few people have been doing them and I think, oh, he's just not doing the songs justice because they're great songs.
Oh, they're wonderful,
you know.
Yeah,
there's
there was a group that started doing them 2 or 3 years ago, wasn't there?
Was there?
Yeah, and it was, you thought, oh well, it's nice that they like these songs. But they don't do them very well.
Right, that's the problem. There was one album of various artists, probably from about 10 years ago, and it was done at Abbey Road, and the proviso was that everybody who did it had to sing live with the orchestra, and so these kind of really good pop stars. And it was fantastic. George Martin was producing. It was fantastic. The big band, the whole orchestra in the studio. And it was really, really good.
Oh,
get hold of a copy for that. I'm sure I've got the documentary on it. It's a bit like the one of West Side Story. Have you seen the documentary?
Oh, yes.
With Tira Kitsapana.
Yes,
where
they lost their tempers.
Yeah.
And what's the name? Went down to the doors.
And he couldn't get his voice, could he?
Theo the Porco. About Leonard Bernstein.
That's right, yeah.
And I thought, yes, but you should hear yourself, darling.
And Leonard Bernstein was so cool about it. It was great, you know. Yeah, it was really good. Turkey Takano was fantastic in that. She was really amazing. But
what was the guy called? He's the one with the three tenors.
And he keeps calling him Pepe, which annoyed him, I think. Leonard Bernstein called him Pepe, Pepe.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And it got on his nerves. What was he called? Jose...
Carreras.
Carreras, yes. That's it. Yeah.
Well, Leonard Bernstein should have known that he couldn't possibly sing like that. And that's that.
But some of the
actors... Because tenors... only care about producing tone. They don't care about tempo or stresses. They care about that wonderful sound.
And he was losing the tempo. And of course, you know, Bernstein was so strict on that because it's a difficult piece anyway to play. And he was losing the tempo and Bernstein was getting really mad with it, you know. But I thought some of the supporting vocalists were better.
Well, of course, naturally. You know. I mean, because they're used to doing that sort of thing.
But it was quite a nice insight into it. It was very, very good.
Did you ever see that film Woody Allen did called Everybody Says I Love You.
No, I've not seen that.
Everybody in it had to sing, whether they could sing well or not. And often they couldn't, and they did dances, like a film musical. Right. It was so divine. And there was one lovely sequence with these two 13-year-old girls sitting at the breakfast table singing I'm Through With Love. It was so delicious.
I'll have to check that one. That's my kind of thing.
You've got to see it.
I'm Through With Love.
What did they say?
They're getting to make sure that you get guidance from now on.
Get what?
Guidance.
Oh, that's good. Because you know... Guidance from now on.
Do you like Woody Allen?
Oh yeah, like anything. Apparently, do you like the last one? Though?
Apparently he doesn't. He just gives you ideas and lets you sort of ad lib and stuff.
He does let you if you can,
yeah.
Doesn't he?
Yeah.
God, in that Manhattan one, he and Diane Keaton, you could see they were ad libbing, but they knew each other so well. Where he was like a detective. Did you ever see that film, High Anxiety?
Oh, Mel Brooks, yes.
Where he's at this nightclub and they ask him to sing and he says, oh, I sing, you know, some standard, in B-flat. Which is don't something I've always wanted to be able to do.
Hey, it's great when all people go, because with playing the clubs and the people go, oh, I do it in copy key.
Yes.
You know, and of course, they've said that, they've heard people say that before.
Yes.
Copy key, you know, it could mean anything.
Yes, you know. Right.
Copy key.
Because you don't happen to have the copy in the front.
It could be E-flat, F or...
And it's usually high, because it sounds better to play in a bright key.
Yeah, B-flat's quite high, yeah, for
a... Honey. Oh, God. What I would like more than anything in the world is to be somebody who can sit and sing at the piano.
Oh, I can't. I'd love to. I can't. Oh, you sing and I play, you mean?
No, where they play and sing simultaneously.
Oh, right, yeah.
Like David Henniker used to. He used to play all the time at the embassy. And he sang songs that were ever so old, even then, like sort of My Canary's Got Circles Under Its Eyes. So sweet. But he sang in this very dry way, very sophisticated. And it was just, you know, this and that and that. And it was lovely. And he used to live in Bruton Place. And I thought, oh, God, that man is perfect.
Where's Bruton Place?
Well, exactly. It's a beautiful little street just off Berkeley Square.
Ah, right.
And it's just lovely. And I thought, well, he would live somewhere like that.
Fenella?
Yeah?
Do you want to have a shot at passive manipulation, the white stripes?
All right. Yes.
Okay.
You see, I shall miss it. Don't give me the cue. I'll do it wild. Because I'll only miss it. Because I don't believe it. Shall I go? I see a ship in the harbour. I see a ship in the harbour. All right. I see a ship in the harbour.
Right.
So we've done that.
You've done that. We've covered the others. What else?
I'm bound to get it wrong.
I think we've got a copy.
What, darling?
Oh, I have a copy.
Do you need the words?
Oh, I think I might have it.
I've got a spare.
I'm going through it. Through
it's not written on.
You all right? You've got a copy, yeah. Okay.
Got it.
You're doing very well.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, darling. Hang on. I'm just pouring out.
Oh, right. How are you doing? Well, that's fine. I'll just leave it on there.
Which is so interesting, you know.
Yes.
Somebody pouring a bottle of water. It's riveting. Depends who does it, of course.
It certainly does.
David Blaine. So he didn't do it, but he got paid something ridiculous like $7 million or something.
Did he?
For holding his breath, was it, or something?
For 7 minutes. Bloody good, you know.
It's good money for the...
A million a minute. Yeah. Well, he nearly died.
But what's all that about anyway?
Don't ask me, darling.
And in ice or on top of what statue or something, he stands there for days on end. It's kind of a boring life to me, that.
Yeah, but I suppose if it's your ambition, then you work up...
It's the oddest ambition to have, isn't it? But school, what's your ambition? Oh, to stand on Trafalgar Square for 3 days, you know.
I know, it is strange, isn't it? But, you know, people do have ambitions for all sorts of strange occupations, don't they?
And I seen him on this morning, I think, and they were trying to get him to talk.
And he couldn't.
And he wouldn't. And I think that's an act as well he puts on, to be honest.
He's trying to be detached. Do you think?
I think it's an act, yeah. I do. I think it's part and parcel of his lifelong ambitions that he's going through one by one.
I think he's done it all now.
Women, listen to your mothers. Don't just succumb to the wishes of your brothers. Take a step back, take a look at one another. You need to know the difference between a father and a lover. Women, listen to your mothers. Don't just succumb to the wishes of your brothers. Take a step back, take a look at one another. You need to know the difference between a father and a lover. Women, listen to your mothers. Don't just succumb to the wishes of your brothers. Take a step back, take a look at your mother. You need to know the difference.
Well, you need to know the difference. It was only once.
Yeah.
Just one... just one mistake. Yes.
Do you want to try it slightly lower?
Yes.
A lower take, yeah. Mm.
Women, listen to your mother. Women, listen to your mother. Don't just succumb to the wishes of your brothers. Take a step back, take a look at one another. You need to know the difference between a father and a mother.
Why doesn't do a lower one?
Listen to your mothers. Don't just succumb to the wishes of your brothers. Take a step back, take a look at one another. You need to know the difference. Mm.
Yeah, I like that.
I like that,
yeah.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of takes on that now in three different keys.
And this might be
I kind of like that. It's
Steve Boyce likes it. Well, I think it's good to record that.
Yeah, I think we've
record
got it.
His opinion. Because, you know, mm-hmm. You're the musician.
I mean, the others might be better, but I do, that's kind of more laid back. I kind of be, yeah. Puts a bit of guitar or something behind that.
It's nice. And it's more different for
yeah.
Him, isn't it?
Yeah.
Good take, that one for another.
Yeah? You like that?
Yes, I do, yeah. Steve, did you want to do some on the Kylie Minogue?
Do we? Or Kylie Minogue, do you want to do? Or do you want to listen to it? Or do you want to... Yeah, 5 to 10 minutes, yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to take a little bit of a recess, I think, if that's okay with everybody.
All right.
Yeah? Thanks.
Okay.
Recess. Is that the right word, recess?
I like it.
It's good enough.
I think it's
I've
good.
Heard it somewhere before.
Yeah. Yeah. Remit.
Reflex.
I think we ought to take a 5 minute reflex.
Yeah, we'll do the other song, Can't Get You Out of My Head, after, and see if we can come to some, like we've done with the other stuff today, we've sort of done it with a different approach with them all, actually, haven't we? Even the Angels, we did like a semi-spoken one, semi-spoken one. That was Did you hear any of that?
That Angels was excellent, I thought.
Was it?
Well, yes, you were just speaking it more or less. But
and even
lovely.
The singing actually was much much more relaxed than previous. Mm. I didn't notice that.
Mm.
No, there was more. It was flowing more than on previous tapes.
See, I suppose that's what
it
is.
We know it all now, don't we? It's there.
Because I've written the words above, and I can see it. I can see what's coming. Not to go moving like that.
It's amazing how a different day or a slightly different alteration of the conditions, like the cameras here and everything, which affects the atmosphere and everything, how that can affect the song, you know, and change. And
it is extraordinary.
So we've got all these marvellous different takes from you now for that song.
I wonder if they'd cut in though, they might be in a different tempo completely.
Well, that's up to
Steve to Wizkid
on that.
I don't like McCaffrey's duets opera. So very often you've got millions of people of different nationalities all in the same thing, but they're singing in Italian. But this girl, he said, was Russian. He said she was marvellous looking, about 26, dressed marvellously and so forth, but she couldn't understand a word of English. So whenever anybody said, you know, like cross left or whatever, she didn't know what they were talking about. And McCaffrey said, I don't know what to do because I don't speak Russian. She said, she managed to say, speak to me. She said it in French, that's what she does now. She said, speak to me. Tell me what to do, and look me in the eyes, and I will understand. And he said she did.
Really?
As long as he looked straight into her eyes, she got it. Isn't it extraordinary? I don't know whether he made that up or not, but I believe.
Well, you do hear stories like that. Very old stories about people just doing something an unusual way, you know. But then, I get people who hear stories like that and they think it's going to work for them, you know, because of the studio. One day I'll write a book about all the, some of them, I can't name names, but you know, they come in the studio and you know, and they start thinking, you think, how on earth did they get to number one? How on earth did they ever do that?
It's like those talent shows, obviously.
The X Factor and all that. Do you know what I think personally? I do like them to on that level of the album, but I think that they've messed a lot of people's heads up. You know, young kids who think that they're going to be huge, they're going to be big, and they're not. And so their dreams have been spoiled, really.
Yes.
Rather than just dream all their lives and never do it, but dream, it's been spoiled. It's all been blown into.
Yes, but it's so terrible when you get somebody coming on and saying, I know I can sing, I've always wanted to sing.
It's my life's
it's
ambition.
My life. And then they come out with it and it's sort of, ugh. And then whoever it is brutally tells them so. Well, isn't it? I mean,
I think it's
they shouldn't have it on the first place.
They shouldn't.
Really.
No, they shouldn't make fun. They do make fun out of a lot of people.
They do it because it's free.
And it's good television. It's not good, but it's television, isn't it? You know,
you do wonder whether they're going to go and jump off the nearest bridge, don't you?
Do you know what? It wouldn't surprise me if there would be one or two of those incidents that happens at some point.
Oh, I'm sure.
Because it wrecks their actual dream.
Yes.
And the dream's great, and they'll never do it, but it will be that dream that they'll always have.
Well,
you know,
very early on, I nearly topped myself because I didn't get into a particular show very early on. I was terribly upset. And I thought, well, I just must be no good, you know. And it wasn't as if... And it was funny because a few weeks later he did ring me to say, I do think you're ever so good, but you're absolutely not right for this show. And so forth. And I tell you who we did have, and then he told me who we did have, and I thought, oh, Well, if I'd realised, then I wouldn't have, you know. But I did feel very near the edge. I did get large bottles of aspirin.
Well, there is that, but there's the ones, the PB's talent shows, and they haven't got any talent. Full stop. I mean, it's...
But lots of... Everybody thinks they're good.
I know.
I mean, that's the terrible thing in life.
Well, I don't know. No, I'm not a big water fan.
Nor am I, but today I'm very keen on it.
Some people say you should drink a pint of water every morning, isn't it?
Well, they say if you're having tea or coffee, that constitutes for quite a lot of it, believe it or not. I don't know.
I probably have 3 mugfuls of tea every morning. And I'm sure it doesn't do me any good, but I do.
No, I do. I'm like that. I can't. I've got to, first thing is, you know. And of course the smoke, well, what's that line upside down? Have you had breakfast? Yeah, I have. You can hardly call 10 cups of tea and 20 Marlboro breakfast. You want to do some singing? Singing, is that what we're going to do now?
Singing?
So,
well, yeah. La 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 la.
Do you want to do that one?
Shall we do that?
Shall we do that?
Right. Okay.
No, I think you flicked. Oh, it's very hot, don't touch it.
Oh, don't touch it, yes.
Very.
Oh, good, I'm glad there's another one. Because it's fabulous, I can't get over it. I'm so stupid, I'm so easily pleased.
Not a great,
that. It's a thrill.
There, I want to wear it so that I can touch that.
That
one that's, yeah, in the, no, beyond it. No, sit on the left, go left,
in
go left,
the
in the lighting box.
You work here all the time.
To your left.
Just to the left.
To your left. Oh. No, to the right now. Oh, there yeah. It is. I'm sorry.
It's like a golden shot, that. I felt like Anne Thingy, what's she called? Anne, do you remember from Golden Shot? She was the hostess, Anne something she was called.
Die, but much prettier than
her. Anne Aston. That was
an
end. I'd like to work with all the carry-on team.
Well, I only did 2 carry-on films, but it was lovely working with them because they were all extremely talented, and that makes life very easy for all of you.
Mm. Well, was it as much fun off the set as it evidently was, you know, sort of...
I think so. I think everybody got on well with each other for that very reason. Because they worked well together and they liked each other because of that.
Mm.
But they might have anyway, but I think because of that is a huge help.
Yes, yes. Sorry, let me get you... Oh, right.
It's the only thing I can think of at the moment.
Right,
Tim, I love the contrast.
It's a bit of a come down, isn't it?
Wonderful.
Right.
There's the screen.
It's
the only other lamp I can find in the building at the moment.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't my little bedside lamp.
Oh, darling.
We don't have that.
It's very nice of you to sacrifice it for art.
Oh, and it needs
art.
That's not going to be bright enough, is it?
It's not going to be quite what the other one was. I mean, could we take the shade off it. I mean, I don't know what...
That would help a bit.
Yes, it would. That's a...
God, the difference between the two is unbelievable. Do you think this will be all right when there's a new bulb?
I'm sure I can sort it out, yeah, I mean...
Is it more complicated than just a new bulb?
I think it's probably 2 new bulbs.
Is that one halogen as well?
I haven't looked yet.
No. But it's a wonderful light to work
with. It is.
I mean, I've not used my specs.
Excellent.
And you didn't want to do that, did you? So it's...
No.
It's as well. Let's hope this does the trick.
Well, it'll be very helpful indeed, darling.
Yes. Shall I give you back the shave? You put it back by your bedside.
I think I'll wear it actually as a hat.
Yes.
To suit the occasion.
Oh, yes. Darling, you'll have to be very forgiving.
Yes. There we are. That's not as... That doesn't look as good.
Okay, all you're going to do is pass yes. that to me at the right place.
Yes, indeed. Now, don't drop it on Fenella.
I can see you're going to be an amazing person in a few years' time, too. No top job will be closed to you.
I'm going to now go right, stick it up on... In fact, I should probably have gone for that beam, because I'm sticking to the fabric. But... Does it matter?
Shall I move?
It might be a good idea, actually.
Shall I just take your microphone off?
I'm loving it, I'm loving it.
Now listen, people are getting too giggly.
Yes.
Yeah, if you want to ask me anything, darling, do it now.
Just while we're waiting for them to decide on what they're doing, how do you find working with Savoy, with all...
Well, it's marvellous because it gives you liberty to go in all kinds of directions, and they're the ones who initiate it.
Yes.
But you know about going in different directions. I found that, you know, I made a distinct mark so early on that it was very difficult for me to do other things, and I had to make sure that people knew I wanted to do other things and kind of get into them.
Yes.
You know, get into my first Shakespeare, get into my first Ibsen, and so on and so on.
Did you have to wait a long time before you got the Shakespeare and the Ibsen, really?
Well, not after I'd sort of... I had a marvellous breakthrough in a musical that I did a long-running review, both in the West End, and the review was with Kenneth Williams. And after those two things, I was able to say to people, oh God, I'd love to do some Shakespeare. Oh, you're doing, why don't I play such and such? And for them to say, yes, you know, it was nice. Mm. And things happen like that. If people know you're open, they're sometimes willing to take a gamble, but normally it would be regarded as a terrific gamble. But Dave and Mike seem to think, you know, there's no limit to it, which is lovely.
That is good, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is very good. Mm. What's been your favourite sort of Shakespeare role?
I haven't done that many.
Right.
I was in As You Like It. I'm trying to think, really, because I've done lots and lots of Shakespeare, but not necessarily in the plays. Mm. I made an arrangement of sonnets, because it's wonderful what you can do. I mean, the Shakespeare sonnet, obviously I mean that. If you put them in a different order, they start to mean different things. So I did that with a group, and it worked out wonderfully. Mm. And so that was a splendiferous thing.
Oh, yes, really well, absolutely.
And so forth. You see, you don't necessarily go from one thing to another to another. You might go do that and then go that way and so forth. It's a question of time and availability. Sometimes when you're asked to do that, you can't because you're already doing that.
Yes.
And so on. Dear, it's 3:10. Why are they taking so long to...
I want him. How old is he? Half my age. Fabulous. 23 and he's gay and he's Spanish.
Get away.
My life.
What's his name?
I don't know, but who cares?
What, another square?
Go on then, yeah. Please. Thank you. Oh, something about... No, there's a... Oh, there's something in there and it's really annoying. I mean, it's because I can't think of what it is, but I smell it.
Looks like that potato plate. It sweats you like.
Maybe the 23-year-old Spanish boy will like it.
Yeah, let's see if you like him.
We're 23. He's 23 and he's Spanish, I'm pretty sure I will. Do you know, I went all the way to Dublin on a blind date once, about 10 years ago.
To Dublin?
To Dublin, yeah. To County... I can't remember, I took on this long bus journey which took me forever.
For man?
It was like on these old-fashioned films, you know, these little charabang things.
Dublin, okay.
County Mayo.
County Mayo?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I got on a plane and just went. I jumped on the plane in Manchester Airport and went.
You just went?
I just went one Saturday morning.
I don't know what to say. I don't know.
He lives in Rochdale now.
You've gone off him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, is he out of reach?
Yeah.
Just that little whiff of...
romance.
Unavailability.
Yes.
Is Mike in there?
Hi, Fenella.
Okay.
That was very good. Could you try it in a lower register now? Thank you.
I just can't get you out of my head. Boy, your loving is all I think about. I just can't get you out of my head. Boy, it's more than I dare to think about.
Fab, that's exactly, yeah.
Doesn't it sound a bit nasty?
No, I don't think it will. I mean, I can kind of soften that a little bit.
Can you?
But it for the sort of track, I think it suits it well. I can imagine that.
You can go.
I know what the track's kind of going to be like, but you need to have a different approach where you can think, oh yeah, that's really like the meat and potatoes. We've really got it now, you know. To put it bluntly.
Oh, yeah. By George, I think she's got it. There was this direct good Ron Eyre that I'd love to have worked with. I saw a production of his, and afterwards, I thought it was wonderful. And afterwards, I talked to some of the actors in it, and I said, I love the way when you did that scene, you were in a terrible state, but you kept holding it back because you were terrified you'd lose your job. And he said, oh, that was Ron's idea. And everything I said, oh, I loved the bit where so-and-so, every single actor, that was Ron's idea, that was Ron's idea. And, you know, actors really, on the whole, if they give a lovely performance, they love it when people think they thought of it all themselves. So it shows how lovely he must have been, that they wanted very much to credit him. That it was his idea. He said, he suggested do it like that. And that, you know, is quite rare. And Trevor Nunn is another. I saw this Othello at the Young Vic that he directed with Ian McKellen and Willa White, the black opera singer. And with that, you know, chatting with Ian, I said, you know, I love the bit where I love the way it was, had this whole barrack room atmosphere in that business where you're laying the plot. That was all Trevor's idea. It was all Trevor, all. And I love the way you knew that nothing could go right, you know, after this, this and this. It was all because of Trevor. And, you know, there's got to be a lot to that. I just can't get you out of my head. Boy, it's more than I dare to think about.
That was the one. I'm having that one. I'm having that one. That one with the previous one, I can chat you up, double track you.
All right, darling.
I'm thinking little production things as I'm going along the way. Matching bits up from 5 minutes ago. I'm thinking, I'll take that and we'll do that.
Yeah.
And the notation was great and the delivery was really good as well.
Oh, well, that's...
It's quite a powerful... I know you're tired, but it's quite a powerful delivery, which is great.
It's being so hot. Yeah. That's a horrible thing. Oh, God. I'm not going to go out in the sun again if it's like this tomorrow. It's just not a good idea, is it?
Aircon. It makes a little bit of a noise, but...
We can put up with it.
I'll live with that.
So I can't have anybody passing out.
Is this air conditioning?
No. 18 is, can get reasonably cool in a short while.
I don't understand it. Is it 18 degrees that keeps it up?
Yeah.
That's
without.
80? No, not 80. We'd be fainting.
Well, yes.
Where's that Spanish boy when he's needed?
Darling.
To be smutted on myself.
When are you going to meet him? Tonight?
No. I don't know. My friend just said, oh, this is 23-year-old fella. You've got to meet him. I need some advice about him or something, but you've got to meet him again. I'm like, oh. Brush up on my Spanish, I think. I'll have to learn the sleep bed.
Hola. Hola.
Hola. I know some very
hola.
Words. Hola. Hola.
Scorchio.
Scorchio, yeah.
La la la. I can't remember it. Oh yes, of course.
I just can't get you out of here.
It's one la 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 la, I just can't get you out of my mind. It's one la dropped off, isn't it?
Yeah, I see what you're saying. Yeah, well, I need to go into it.
Yeah,
can't
you say I. Yeah.
Lip sync.
That's out. Set me free. Feel the need in me. Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine because she's going, "Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z-Z Right, this is just the other deep in your arms or whatever it is. I've got to say something else then.
Have you got any ambitions left?
Loads and loads.
What would you like to?
Oh, I can't possibly tell you. It's much better not to tell because I think it's bad luck.
Oh, right. I think there might be some truth in that.
Well, you know, it's like saying you've got the job and then finding out, God, you haven't. And if you'd not said, you would have.
Yes, of course. That's right. Everybody would be looking for you then. It's not made it yet.
It's extraordinary, all that. What's that glass of water?
That's
yes, disappeared.
Yes.
I'd better have this glass of water.
Here we are.
Yeah. Nobody
will know. Actually, there is one, but you might prefer that.
No, that'll be fine. Right. Yes. I know that.
That's finished, isn't it? So.
That Steve doesn't want water, but.
Yes, I'll put that within reach there as well.
Don't keep it locked in your heart.
Don't leave me locked in your heart.
That's the one for me. Mike!
It's very bony, isn't it?
It's kind of nice. I like the more forceful one. And the other thing is, again, if we do the light thing, we're only copying what she's done.
Yes.
You know,
but I don't want to sound sort of like...
Oh, it's not going to sound like... But it's kind of a different tone and different approach. But if it was just to copy her, it'd be like, oh, she's just trying to do what thingy does, you know. So I think a different approach. I mean, we have got all that with you singing it like that. But I kind of, thinking about it like this morning, that I thought I wanted a bit of a more forceful approach on it. Well, I think we've done all that. I reckon I've got all that I need on there. On this specific take, I don't think I need any more.
I think I might burst if we do any more. Oh,
yeah.
But it's cooler.
No, it's sounding good. I think a lot of the stuff you did today was much better.
Yes.
Much better. And it was more, some of them was more forceful, but obviously you've lived for a few days with them now, so... You know, you're a little bit more familiar. We could go higher. We could try it. But it
you
would
mean
even,
higher
but,
and...
Yeah, but even so, it would lose the subtlety then where you do... there's little bits where it is quieter, which is quite nice, but if we move it up, it will lose that
sort of move whispering it down. Song. No, I wouldn't move it down. It'd sound very
But
dirty.
I can sing up if you move it down.
I think it'd sound too much dirty. Then, yeah.
Not much down.
No.
Anyway, darling.
That's great.
Ah. Oh, God, I'm absolutely pooped. I'm not really. I could go until midnight.
Oh, yeah.
Did you get all that you wanted on that?
Oh, I think so. I think we've got loads of really good stuff that we...
I had no idea that the song just went on repeating and repeating. I thought we'd done it when we got to... It's more than I dare to think about. I thought, ah, oh, that's it. Then suddenly my la-la-la. I was jumping back.
Oh, on the full run through?
Yes. Gave me a bit of a turn.
Right. Yes, I would say very much so, yes. Yes.
Well, then, good.
Do you remember that documentary that sort of follows Madonna around? It's in bed with Madonna.
Oh,
do you remember
yes.
that one? I wondered if this could be in bed with Fenella.
Oh, darling.
I'm not going there. I'm not saying anything on the matter.
Nor am I.
Yes. Well, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Great. No,
it's
thank
been
you.
Really, rather fun.